What are they, Captain?
Back!
You must get me treasure!
Leave them to me.
If I desired your assistance, I'd have demanded it. We had the situation under control. Isn't that right, Smee?
Oh, yes, Captain, completely. We would have cleaved those fiends to the brisket, we would. Why, I'd have given them a little of this and this.
And don't think your efforts mean you'll get a share of me treasure, understand?
I'm not after your precious box, Captain. I'm looking for a person. A boy wearing a mask. Ring any bells?
No, not a one.
Figures.
Smee! You blithering barnacle! We're off! We shall leave this place before the light draws them back again.
Oh. Hey, hold on. What did you just say about the light?
Ah, yes, it's heartbreaking, really. This chest, you see, contains light gathered from all around. And I've got an acquaintance, a boy, who's sure to try and seize it.
A boy who's after the light. If it's not Vanitas, then who? Hey, why don't I help you keep the light safe? Maybe you could tell me more about this boy who's troubling you. What's his name?
Peter Pan. This chest must be brought to Skull Rock safely. Don't let that Peter Pan anywhere near it.
Right. I got you covered.
Thank you. gotcha.
Well done.
Pardon me, Captain, but it's about that shooting star I was mentioning to ye.
Mr. Smee, I ordered you to drop that. I'll not have you gushing on about some shooting star.
But Captain, most shooting stars twinkle for a bit and then they go out. But this one, it kept on sparkling and shining even after it crashed down. Why, what if it's really a big, enormous, priceless gemstone?
Idiot! Why didn't you tell me? We've a bit of business to attend to and must, I fear, step away. I trust you can see to things till I return.
Sure. When Peter Pan gets here, I'll be waiting.